Hello! Welcome to the final installment of Minecraft Bootcamp. I am Shewtur, and today we are going to the end, and we're going to defeat the Ender Dragon and claim the Dragon's Egg, one of the rarest items in the game. So, in order to finish the game, as people like to say, you have to journey to the end and defeat the Ender Dragon. And just like the Nether, the end is reached through a portal. The end portal will be located in a stronghold. And just like going to the Nether, we need to make preparations. We need a full set of diamond armor. Not only is the Ender Dragon very powerful, the end is also full of Endermen. So we need a good bow and a sword. I like to have a power 4 bow, at least a sharpness 3 sword. Take cobblestone. Golden apples are a really good option if you can afford to put those together. 2 stacks of arrows. Plenty of food. A piston and lever. We're going to use that for acquiring the dragon egg at the end. Take some water. And then we need Eye of Enders. We're going to use those to find the stronghold. See it flying there? The way we get those is we have to use Ender Pearls and Blaze Rods. We showed you last week how to get the Blaze Rods in the Nether. So you throw it up by right-clicking and it'll fly towards the stronghold. You have to repeat this process until you get close enough to the stronghold, and then we will go down. So see that? We throw it and there it goes. We just keep following these. You can usually pick them back up and use them for a while before they get destroyed. But we follow the eyes. Follow the eye. The eyes of Ender. But these are still flying pretty good, so we keep on following it. Ah, there we go. See that? It went into the ground. That means we are directly over the stronghold. So we want to use our tunneling techniques to make a stairwell in a spiral fashion down into the stronghold. You don't just want to go straight down. Ah, there's the cracked stone. That means we're right on it. In this instance, we actually came into the stronghold. Sometimes you'll get lucky and you'll actually come right down into the room with the end portal. But in this case, we're going to have to do a little exploring. So we're going to wander around, see if we can't find that end portal. So we keep looking around. If you find a library, you can pillage that for books. And there we go. That's what we're looking for right there. This is the end portal. Yeah, you probably want to smack those spawners, but this is what the end portal looks like. And then you have to take the Eye of Enders and place them in each one of those frames around the edge. And once you get it all filled up, bingo, you got a portal. Here we are. All right. Endermen. You'll notice there'll be quite a few Endermen here. So you want to avoid eye contact unless you want to get in a big extra battle in addition to the Ender Dragon battle. So we just keep going around and firing at those crystals. We have to need to destroy all the crystals before we take on the Ender Dragon. And another tip is stay away from the edge of this platform because he likes to knock you off. See how the crystals will heal him? That's that little beam that's going up there. Now, once we get the Ender crystals destroyed, then we can work on this bugger. Fire arrows at him like that. Then he likes to swoop in attack. When he comes in, I'll fire arrows. If he gets close enough, you want to pull out your sword and chop him in half. Is the fountain. So gather up all your XP. And right there on the top is the prize. That is the dragon egg. One of the rarest items in the game. So we want to take our cobblestone and make a little platform here, because once you jump into the fountain, you're going to go back to the world. So we need to use that piston that we brought with us. We set it up like this. And use the lever or a redstone and bam. We got it. You have conquered the end. Then you can gather up some end stone or some obsidian if you want to. You can knock some endermen around if you like to. Endermen are, they do need some knocking around from time to time. If you want to dump the water out, water gets the endermen away from you. That can really help if you're having trouble and the endermen are just swarming you. Dump that water bucket out and they don't like that at all. They'll get away from you. So look at that. Anyway, when you're done, head back over, jump in the end fountain, and it's time for end credits. And we are back. And I'm pretty sure it dumped me right back here where I spawned in the very first episode, I believe. And we look right across the way, and there's the house. I like to make something like this. Drop that bad boy right in there. Bam. Proving to everybody that visits your little house that you are a true warrior. Alrighty, now that you have completed the basic training series, maybe you're willing to go a bit deeper. There's a lot more to Minecraft than just surviving and defeating the Ender Dragon. Take a look at some of this. I hope that you have enjoyed watching Minecraft Bootcamp as much as I've enjoyed making it. I want to give a special thanks to Master64, my trusty companion. He's the reason that I started playing this game to begin with. I thought, at first glance, that this didn't look like a great game. Boy, was I wrong. Please take a moment to write something in the comment section below if you have found this series helpful. I'm always looking for new, exciting games to play, so your suggestions will be very helpful to me in the future. Good luck on your adventures in this awesome world of Minecraft, and I will see you next time. Shewtur out.